In Keene, workers on Stonewall Farm divide their attention between the dairy and its visitors.
But in Gilsum, attention focuses only on healing.
Manual labor is good, good therapy.
My name is Mike Rivers. I run the DV Farm here in Gilsum, New Hampshire. We don't grow crops. The land is used as a rehab tool to keep our vets engaged in projects daily as they go through their journey of recovery from drugs and alcohol.
The name DV Farm says it all. The letters stand for dysfunctional veterans.
The goal here is to take those vets that have fallen through the cracks. I'm looking for the problem children, the ones that have, 30-day, 60-day programs don't work for. First, let's start with the appointments.
Mike knows the demons that haunt his residents from his own experience.
Well, I was homeless many years on the streets of Boston, done many types of programs through the VA, close to 40 detoxes.
The DV program is based on what ultimately worked for Mike, a rural setting, a job caring for non-judgmental animals, with responsibility increasing over time. Mike started the DV farm out of a deep desire to pay back the help he received. But how did this formerly homeless man get himself and his project off the ground?
I started a Facebook page called Dysfunctional Vets, DV for short. I connected with fellow vets that share my sense of sarcasm, dark sense of humor, our take on life. And the page has grown to almost 1.5 million likes.
He started selling t-shirts online featuring veterans' blunt sentiments.
It started with the traditional DV shirt that just said, dysfunctional vet, leave me alone. And that sold thousands of shirts. Dysfunctional veteran does not play well with others. I break for IEDs, that's a bumper sticker. Next thing you know, I have an income.
With that, Mike got an apartment, saved money. Next came the farm.
It was all wooded when we got here and the vets helped clear the land.
David is a resident here. He spent 8 years in the Air Force.
I had a lot of issues with alcohol. And I've now been here 19 months, which equals my sobriety also.
Ben has been at DV Farm for 6 weeks.
This program is a lot different. It's not such a sterile clinical environment, which helps a lot.
Now, back in Keene, there's one more thing you should know. If you're looking for a family outing that includes livestock and hay rides, this is it. Or maybe it's hiking and outdoor activities you desire. It's here. Or you're searching for a sweet wedding location. Look no further. Welcome to Stonewall Farm.
Norman Chase was fourth generation to be here, and he wanted the land to be preserved. Mike Kidder is the man who started this. He came along and said, Norman, I want to save the farm and save the land. And so how about if I buy this from you?
And that's just what happened. Megan Burke Kidder was one of the founders who turned the farm into a nonprofit community resource that now includes a learning center, land for activities, all while still operating a real, working organic dairy.
The goal is to teach people about the importance of agriculture today, and also specifically organic.
Visitors are welcome to visit the dairy barn. Yes, cows. Cows being milked, about to give birth, and newborns. And then, of course, you gotta have a barn dog named Rooster. Outside, horses, goats, and this little building is fascinating. A museum of ice cutting equipment from days long gone by.
People from all over New England and beyond can come here, and anybody can come and enjoy it at any time. We're open year round.
And some of that milk from Stonewall Farm is actually used in Stonyfield yogurt.
That's true. And of course, it's seasonal at the farm, different things during different seasons. In the summertime, there's biking, there's lots of gardening, of course, and there's actually a summer camp as well. So lots of things to do in both seasons there. That's Chronicle for tonight. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Anthony Edwards.
And I'm Shana Seymour. Have a great one, everyone. We'll see you tomorrow night.